Hello and welcome to SciJoy. Today we're going to learn about Van de Graaff generators and make some out of household items. To figure out what materials we need for our generator, we need to look at the Triboelectric series and the principles of static electricity. Static electricity is created when two materials rub together and one gives up electrons and becomes positively charged, while the other gains electrons and becomes negatively charged. Materials most likely to give up electrons, like hair, are at the top of the series, while materials most likely to gain electrons, like latex, are at the bottom. I chose nylon from the top of the list and vinyl from the bottom to be the materials for our rollers. Let's look at the components of the Van de Graaff generator and how it works. The upper dome is made of metal. There's an upper comb attached to the dome, and it reaches out towards the upper nylon roller. There's a belt wrapped around the upper and lower rollers. The lower roller is covered in vinyl and positioned near the lower comb. This comb is grounded. All the parts start out neutral since there is no movement. It is important to note that only electrons are transferred between atoms or molecules, not protons. Any plus signs designate positively charged atoms or molecules, not protons themselves. As the belt rubs against the nylon roller, it loses electrons and becomes positively charged. And the vinyl roller gains electrons and becomes negatively charged. After this charge is built up, the belt brings down electrons to the lower vinyl roller. Since this roller is already negatively charged, it repels the electrons on the belt. So let's take a closer look at this. These negative charges push the electrons away from the combs. The negative charges on the roller and belt repel the electrons in the comb, which is grounded. This causes the electrons in the comb to move to earth ground, leaving positively charged molecules. The negative belt and the roller, in combination with the positively charged comb, now create an electric field. There's air molecules between the belt and the comb that are bouncing around and colliding with each other. When a molecule nears the comb, an electron is stolen. This electron moves down the wire to ground. The air molecule is now positively charged and ionized, and is bouncing around and colliding with all the other air molecules. And when the charged air molecule hits a neutral one, it steals its electron. The chain reaction of shoving and stealing happens until we get next to the belt again. The negative belt will give up its electron to the ionized air molecule, making the belt positive. The belt returns to the top roller electron deficient. Since the belt and the roller have the same charge, they repel each other. But this time, instead of the electrons in the comb being repelled, they are attracted to the belt. Another electric field is created, and the belt steals electrons from the air molecules. These ionized air molecules gain electrons from collisions with each other and eventually from the upper comb. The electrons in the upper comb are replenished by stealing ones from the dome, and then the belt is sent back down to the lower roller negatively charged. This depletion of electrons leaves the outside of the dome positively charged, and when you stand on an insulated surface and put your hand on the dome, the electrons travel from you to the dome, and this makes your hair stand on end because they are positively charged and repelling each other. To make this, you're going to need a plastic Tupperware container. You need to cut a hole in the top for the rubber band to fit through, but not so big that the PVC pipe has nowhere to stand. Drill or cut a hole in the sides of the Tupperware container for the lower roller to go. The lower roller just has to be long enough to attach to a motor, which in our case is a drill. I wrap the lower roller in vinyl electrical tape. You also have to cut the top off of a plastic bottle that is wide enough for a soda can to rest. Cut a hole in the bottom for the rubber band to fit through. Cut a piece of PVC pipe and drill a hole in the top for the upper roller. Make sure you position the upper roller high enough to stretch out the rubber band, which will allow the upper roller to turn when the lower one does. I covered the upper roller in nylon. Carefully cut the top off a soda can to make a dome. Strip a piece of stranded wire and attach one end to the inside of the soda can. The other end should hover just above the upper roller and spread out the strands to make it like a comb-like structure. Strip a second piece of wire. The comb-like end should be near the lower roller, while the other end should be grounded. Slowly turn the drill to charge the Van de Graaff generator. I used a tissue to show the charges build up, and you can see when I put my hand near the tissue, they become attracted to each other. You can also use the grounded end of the lower comb as a type of wand. Thank you for joining us today on SciJoy to learn about Van de Graaff generators and to build some. If you decide to build some at home, please let us know. You can share your experiments with us on Twitter, Facebook, Tumblr, down in the comments below. If you decide to make one similar to ours, or maybe with some different materials, or maybe one that's even more powerful, and instead of using a soda can, you could use something like two giant salad bowls. Don't use stuff from your parents' kitchen or from your roommate. I found out that does not go over very well.